हाय स्टूडेंट, आई एम अशित तिवारी। टुडे आई विल सॉल्व द लेसन नंबर फर्स्ट ऑफ द ज्योग्राफी इंडिया लोकेशंस एंड दिस इज़ अ टेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज। इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू डिस्कस ऑल दीज क्वेश्चंस। इट विल आल्सो वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू। सो लेट्स वी बिगिन द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द बुक्स टेक्स एक्सरसाइज। आई विल रीड द क्वेश्चंस एंड यू विल जस्ट लिसन इट एंड before listing it you just make sure that you have a books and you should also pen and pencil and one notebook also. It will also make your clear understanding with the questions and their answer. So as I will just read the questions and solve the answers only. Which one of the following latitudinal extent is relevant for extent of India area? So it is a 8°41' north and 37°6' north. Means I am telling about this line, long latitude lines. So this is the first question's answer. Second question: Which one of the following countries share the longest land frontier with Bangladesh? Obviously, it is Bangladesh, because from there to there the length is near about 4,000+ kilometer. This is the longest land frontier which share with India of the Bangladesh. So obviously, the Bangladesh is the right answer. Then our third question: Which one of the following countries is larger in area than India? So obviously this is the China, because China is only the groups, because I have told you there are the six countries which are larger than India: Russia, Canada, USA, then Brazil, China, Australia. So these are the six countries which are larger than India, and three countries which are not in the groups which I have told. Next question, we have the answer also. Question number 4, it is alternative questions. All these first set of the questions, here are the all alternatives. Which one of the following longitude is the standard meridian of India? So obviously I will draw this line, and it is the 82 degree and 30 east. It is known as a Indian standard meridian, because it is the imaginary line which divides India longitudinally half, and which also used as a standard meridian which divide the country from half and half, from the east and west, so that we have no any kind of problems or the botheration over the time. The region, I will tell the region later. So student, these are the first set of the question where I have told the alternatives of the questions answer, and I have just pick up the right answer from the alternatives. And now I will discuss the second set of the questions, and I will discuss their answer. Second set of the question, I will also read them, and you just listen the questions and then I will explain the answer. Means I will just tell the answer by the drawings. Does India need to have more than one standard time? If yes, why do you think so? The reason is that India need more than one time zones, more than one standard time, because this is the Tropic of Cancer, and there are near about 30 longitude lines, and the reason is that on each 15 longitude line there is 1 hour. Obviously there are 2 hours, and we are following the one time zone in the entire country. Even we have the possibilities of the two time zone. So this is the first strong reason that we should have the you'll see two time zones or more than one time zone. Second reason is that the Earth, which tilted toward the Sun, so this part received the much rays or rays earlier, and this part does not take the you'll see sun rays very earlier. Means this area experience the very earliest times or see the or just welcome the sun rising, and this part of the Earth you will say witness for the late sun setting. So obviously these are the two regions that the tilted part of the Earth toward the sun receive the maximum sunlight and receive the sun rising first. So these are the second region. And third region is that many countries in the world, such as Russia, America, Canada, have more than one time zone. So obviously India, why should not have that more than one time zone? So student, hope you could understand well all these answers. Then second questions, what are the implications of India? What are the implications of India having a long coastline? So this is our second set of the question from the group second. So we will discuss the question number one. We have the long coastline where it is up to this is 7516.6 kilometer. Obviously this is long coastline, which is very long, and many other countries have not the such a long coastline. So the long coastline very will say good for the export and import, especially for the eastern countries and for the western countries. Second thing is that the Deccan Plateau, which just protrudes to the Indian Oceans, and it link the Indian Oceans, Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. Obviously Deccan, I will tell this peninsular area of India. Peninsular means the part of land which is covered by the water on the three sides. So you'll say Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal, then Indian Ocean. So obviously this area just very you'll say good for the three areas water, which is also very good. Third one region is that there is the Trans Indian Oceans, means many of the other countries ships also go through it. So obviously this is the international, we'll say, track, international sea route. So India also got the benefit from this Trans-Indo Oceans route. So it is also very good for India. Now student, we will discuss the third question from the second set. Obviously you should also getting the enjoyment with the kind of such explanation. It will also help you to just openly to solve the questions. How is the latitudinal spread of India advantageous to her? Means this is the latitudinal spread, and I will tell very important things. This is the Tropic of Cancer, which divide the India into the two halves. One, this is called the north part, this is called the south part. North part is called the tropics, subtropical region, subtropic, and this is called the tropic. India comes in the temperate zone, number one thing. So obviously temperate zone, which very you'll say profitable for the good type of the climate, and good type of the climate which also give the, you'll say, advantage to the biodiversity. एंड बायोडाइवर्सिटी वेयर देयर इज़ ए गुड रेंज ऑफ द फ्लोरा एंड फोना. यू हैव सीन दैट देयर आर मोर देन 5 टाइप ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट एंड डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ द स्पीसीज विच हैज़ बीन फाउंड इन द इंटायर कंट्री विच आल्सो फाउंड इन द इंटायर वर्ल्ड एज वेल. सो वी हैव द रिच टाइप ऑफ द वेराइटीज. सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट द लैटिट्यूडनल स्प्रेड वेयर द यूल से एरिया विच इज ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी गुड फॉर द ऑल टाइप ऑफ एडवांटेज विच मे रिजल्ट फॉर द गुड सेंस फॉर द यूल से प्रॉफिट और मेनी काइंड ऑफ द रीजन्स. इंडिया हैव ए लॉट ऑफ एडवांटेज ऑफ द लॉन्ग यूल से लैटिट्यूडनल स्प्रेड. So this is also help for India, for the climate, for the biodiversities, and for the reason is that the area which you'll say the sun rays which reaches from east part to west part take 2 hours time. So it is also good for the different type of the cultures, means geographicals. You will say varieties which we find in the country. So hope you could understand well this answer. Now we have the fourth question of the second set. While the sun rises earlier in the east, say Nagaland and also set earlier, how do watches Kohima and New Delhi show the same time? So student, in the first, the Nagaland beer, the sun rises first and also set earlier, and the sun set earlier means this part which just we'll say lies here in the eastern part of the country, and there are the 30 longitude lines and 30 longitude lines where the sun rises first in the east direction. Obviously there are the 2 hours, means there are 30 lines and each longitude lines have the 4 minute gap, 4 minute durations. Obviously sun have to travel from east to west, take the 2 hours time, so there is a lot of you will say confusion over the time. Means if the person who is Kohima in New Delhi, Kohima and New Delhi, obviously there is a gap more than 1 hour, and if the gap is more than 1 hour, obviously it will also affect the our system, because our system is mostly run by the internet, and if the internet is affected by the watches, then there will be the impact in the bankings, in the railways, in the communications, and many of the areas where it will also impacted. Not very positively, very negatively. So India have decided the one time zone which passes through the Mirzapur. Mirzapur is a city of UP, and where it is declared as a Indian standard meridian, and we have calculated from the Greenwich meridian. Means we have multiples with the 7 degree and 30 east. So obviously we have the 82 and 30 east longitude lines are there, means our country is tilted towards the east direction, so we use only the E. So student, in such a way we declare the one time zone to avoid the kind of confusion, to avoid the kind of this problems or the botherations. So obviously it will also good for the country. Every country have make it possible to have the one time zone. If the latitudinal extent is much larger, then there is the compulsion to have more than one time zone. So student, you could understand well all these solution which I explained here of the questions. Thank you to watching it. Thank you to listening it.